Good evening. This evening I'm going to attempt to cover COS1512 2022 assignment 3 question 3. This is to with regards to defining a class called movie. Okay, so let's go ahead and read what they've got to say. I will show it on the display quickly. Here we go. So, question 3. What they've said is, consider the class movie that contains information about a movie. The class has the following attributes. It has a movie name, and it has the SA Film and Publication Board, FPB rating, for example, A, PG, 7 to 9 PG, 10 to 12 PG, 13, 16, 18, X18, and double X. The number of people that have rated this movie as 1, the number of people that have rated this movie as 2, the number of people that have rated this movie as 3, the number of people that have rated this movie as 4, the number of people that have rated this movie as 5. Okay, it asks here, please implement the class with an accessor and mutator functions for the movie name and the FPB rating. Write a function, add rating, that takes an integer and as an input parameter. The function should verify that the parameter is a number between 1 and 5, and if so, increment the number of people rating the movie that match the input parameter. For example, if 3 is the input parameter, the number of people that rated the movie as 3 should be incremented by 1. Write another function, get average, that returns the average value for all of the movie ratings. Finally, add a constructor that allows the programmer to create the object with a specified name and FPB rating. The number of people rating the movie should be set to 0 in the constructor. Test the class by writing a main function that creates at least 2 objects, adds at least 5 ratings for each movie, and outputs the movie name, the FPB rating, and the average rating for each movie. So I didn't read the last part, but I will make the adjustments. Test the class by writing a main function that creates at least 2 objects, adds at least 5 ratings for each movie, and outputs the movie name, the FPB rating, and the average rating for each movie object. All right, so without further ado, let's go ahead. We're gonna go to our code blocks. You might notice this is a bit of a new screen. I'm busy testing out a new computer, so it might look a bit different. I'm gonna choose a C++ source. I'm gonna go next. I want a C++. I'm going to go here and I want to create a new folder, and I'm going to call this question 3. Okay, and then we're going to put this in as question3.cpp. Okay, so that's my path. All right, click on finish. So I've got a blank file at the moment. Okay. And what I want to do is I want to go and add it to the, I want to add a name to it to show that it's question 3. Okay, so in order to do that, I'm going to put in my comments. I'm going to say assignment 3, question 3. All right. Because I'm only going to use IO stream, I actually am also going to use string, so I'm going to just have these includes. Include and IO stream, and then we also want to include string, and then we obviously gonna use using namespace standard. Okay. We create our class called movie, and we start adding our header information. So I'm gonna put my functions in public, and I'm gonna create a default constructor. Then I want to create an overload function. So I'm going to be using two strings, and so I'm going to have the name as the movie name, and then a string and the FPB rating. Okay, and this is my overloaded constructor. I think that's what it was meant to be. Constructor. Okay, then I'm going to obviously use my setters or mutators. So my first one is going to be set the name of the movie. Okay, that's going to be in this in the form of string name, and as I say, that's a setters or mutators. Then the next one's going to be void and set rating. This is also going to be a string. Then the next thing is I'm going to use my getters. So I'm going to put string, and I'm going to say get, and we want to get the name of the movie, and because we don't want to make any changes, we're using const. So I call these getters or accessor functions. My next one is going to be string and get rating, and that's also going to be of const. Okay, and then finally they asked us to add two different functions, and so the one is add rating, and we want int, and I'm putting it as rate value, and this is my create function add rating, and then the other one was the get average. Okay, and I'm making it a const. Function, and now we want to declare our member variables. So I'm going to put them as private, and I want to have it as string name and string rating, and over here I'm going to have int, and I've got terrible, and I'm initializing that to 0. I've got bad, and I'm initializing that to 0. I've got okay, and I'm initializing that to 0. I've got good, and I'm initializing that to 0. And then I've got great, which is being initialized to 0 as well. Okay, so that's the end of my header implementation. On my header file. So now I'm moving on to my actual implementation, and so my implementation is, as I say, you copy this part, you want to be able to implement that, and then this is a class, so you copy that, put that there with our double dots, and now we've got our default default constructor. Okay, and as they said, we've got to initialize the name. So we're going to initialize that to nothing if they use that, and then we're going to go for rating. I'm going to initialize that to nothing. That's all on this one. Then we want our overloaded constructor. So I'm just going to copy this whole piece out here. I want to put that there. I'm going to copy it from here, put it here. And I'm going to take that there and define it. So basically, we're going to say name equals, and we've got the name. Okay, and then we've got rating. Equals to this rating. Alright, so that's my overloaded constructor. Then the next one is my setters and my getters. So I'm going to copy this. I want to make sure it gets part of the the actual class, and then I'm going to just make sure I note that these are the setters, and basically all I'm going to do is go name equals in, because that's been passed in here, and the next one is this one. Sure, it's part of the class. And we go rating. Equals R. R. Okay. Then we want our getters. So I'm just going to copy this whole string here. I'm going to take this part out before I forget, and do this, copy that, and then now I've got get name. So basically all we're going to do is return name. Alright, and then the other one is this one. Forget about it being part of the class, and we want to return, and it's going to be return rating. Okay, so the next thing that we've done the return rating, the next thing we're going to do is move on to our add rating, which is this one over here. So I'm just going to copy this over here. I'm going to take this piece out. I'm going to move this over here. Okay. And then for this one, what I've done is they've said that we needed to make sure that the person enters the correct amount, so the correct value. So I've gone and said if the rate value is greater than 0 and the rate value is less than 6, okay, then it may proceed, and in which case I wanted to perform a switch statement. And I'm going to use the rate value that's passed to it so that it can make use of it. And in case one, is I'm going to increment the terrible option here that's part of this private. I'm gonna say it's gonna get incremented, and you can increment it by one by just putting a plus plus like that. And you mustn't forget to add a break, since we don't want it to try and use case two. So you need your break to be there. Okay, and the next one is the bad. So we're just using that. We're going here, we're going plus plus. Okay, and we've got case three. We're forgetting our break, which I just mentioned earlier. That one is okay. So what we're doing is we're giving a record to each one of these guys. We're incrementing it by one, and we're making sure that it doesn't get added to any other of the cases. So case four is good. Got our plus plus, and then we've got our break, and then our case five is great. Okay, and break. And now, once we're out of the switch statement, that means that if it's within the range 1 to 5, it will execute one of these case statements. But now we've got an if statement, and we're saying, well, if it doesn't have that value, then we need the user to be able to see that there's an error. So we can just say cout error number entered was not 1 to 5, and we can end the line so they can attempt again. So that ends that function. Then the next function we've got is our get average. Now my get average doesn't seem to be working as perfectly as I would like it, but this is still the way I would implement it if it was me submitting something, because the code in itself looks correct, but for some unknown reason it's not giving me a fancy decimal place. So what I've done is I've created two variables, and the first one is an integer, and I've said it can be total. Okay, and I'm initializing that to 0, and then I've got a double one that I'm saying the number of the ratings, and no wait, double, and I've called that average, and I've initialized this to 0.00. okay. And what I've done is I've added a line to show you what the various selected options are displaying. So you don't need to add this line in, but this is a line that I thought was quite interesting, because it actually shows you that the plus plus is working for this. Edit, undo. Good and great. And we'll have an end line. So this line is, that top line is totally optional. The next thing what I've done is I've said get my total to add all of these values. So I've got this, and I'm saying add terrible, add the number of bad entries, okay, add the K one, and add the good one. Great one. Okay, and yeah, so I've asked it to add the total quantity, and then I've set the average to equal the total divided by 5, because we have 5 options there. And so I was hoping for a better result, but at the moment it's just either giving me a rounded figure, it's not giving me any decimal value. So maybe one of you guys can investigate that and tell me what is it that I need to do to make it work. Int main, now defining my main file, so I'm gonna just say main application. Okay, inside here I've got 2 strings, so I'm calling it the movie name. Okay, and then I'm just FPB for short, and then the next one is going to be my number of ratings, any ratings. And what they've said is that we need to allow the people to add things in. So I had created a program that would actually ask you to enter the name of the movie and enter the FPB setting. But let's go ahead and use an example of one that's already done, just so that makes it easier. So obviously we want to create a movie object, and so I'm going to call my first one M1, and I want to initialize that. Let's call it Ghostbusters. Okay, and then I'm going to rate that one as a PG movie. Okay. Then we want to add at least 5 ratings. So let's just go m1.addRatings, and yeah, we can specify what rating we want to put in there. I'm going to use 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I should actually just do a couple of the 5s. Maybe that would. So I'm just going to copy this line. And just put 5s in there. Maybe that will give me some different. So 1, 2, 3, 4. Well, yeah, this is why I wanted to use that. So 3, 4, 5, so you can actually see that what it's doing. Let's just do another 5. So we've got 2 5s and all 1s. Okay. Yeah. Then I will also create another movie object, and we'll call that M2. And I'm just trying to think what the latest movies are, because I hardly get to watch TV. Ghostbusters. Let's put Iron Man. I think people are talking about Iron Man. And we want that one to be rated 18. So we'll just say PG-18. There, and then let's just go m2.addRating, put it on 5, just have this one as high. Okay, and then we mustn't forget to return our zero. And what I did was I created an output here, just before here, and I just said C out, and I put the name so that they can see it. Name, and you can say m1.get name. Line, and then see at FPB rating and one get rating. Okay, and then see at, and I had average rating, and we get m1.getAverage, and L, and then we can do the same with our second movie. We'll just change this to 2. Okay, so let's go ahead and execute that. You must remember that. Semicolon. Alright, this one seems to run a lot faster than the other one. There's no antivirus. So what I was trying to show you guys was that top line. It's the extra line is this line that you're seeing here, where it's giving you 10112, and it's telling you how many things, because you've got 1 for the first one, then 0 for the second one, 1 for the 3, 1 for 4, and you've got 2 for 5, and as you can see here, 0005. But the calculation is only giving me 1, which is not the correct result. It should be giving me a decimal space. But thank you for watching it. I hope that this has been helpful and informative. And all the best with COS1512. Thank you and goodbye.